Some wild conspiracy theories exist about you.
Okay.
Misinformation put out by the Russian government. What's the wildest?
My favorite one is that I'm hired by Hillary Clinton personally to destroy the Russian Orthodox Church and Russia itself.
And are you?
Not to my knowledge.
In 2012, Pussy Riot made international headlines when they staged a protest inside a Moscow cathedral, and they paid a high price.
The all-female group called Pussy Riot has been jailed for 2 years for an anti-Putin performance in a Russian Orthodox cathedral.
What was it like? What did you face inside prison?
I ended up in a labor camp. So the attitude to a prisoner in Russian system didn't change since the Gulag times. People work 16 hours a day with no days off. It's basically like boot camp where they prepare you mostly for just being obedient and losing your sense of identity, losing sense of purpose.
What did they make you do? What was the work?
I was sewing police uniforms.
Nadya says sewing uniforms is now a fairly standard punishment for opponents of the war in Ukraine.
Besides being physical torture, because the equipment is old and outdated and you constantly get injured while doing it, trying to fulfill enormous quotas, it's also psychological torture because with your labor, you support the system that you go against.
Since their release, the group has lived in exile, just where, they won't say, for obvious reasons. But they continue their campaign against Vladimir Putin.
Earlier when we were talking, you said you've had this one job for many years. What's that one job?
My job is to hurt Vladimir Putin as much as humanly possible. Since 2007, I have this job.
Can you do that with art and music and protest?
Yeah, of course, because bullets can penetrate your body, art can penetrate your mind. And we're doing it for years. I've seen so many younger people who would approach me on the street in Russia to hug me and cry and say that I've helped them to come out of closet, or I helped them to go to their first political protest. And there is nothing special about me except that I'm not afraid to speak out. So I'm not a particularly amazing singer or a great artist. I'm just like a person who is not afraid.
Does that make you dangerous?
Some people say so.
Do you think you are?
No, I think I'm nice and cute and fluffy and like really just lovely person.
I've seen some of your music. I don't know about cute and fluffy.
Pussy! Pussy!
This is the whole ethos of Pussy Riot, that anyone can be Pussy Riot. Anyone can join this rebellion. The dictator can be in power only until the majority of people in the country believe that he's strong. So if he collectively refuses to be afraid, Putin is going to be out of office tomorrow.
Putin tries to project an image as being a strong man. Is he strong right now, or is he afraid?
I think he's getting weaker progressively. And the recent situation with the Wagner group attempted military coup really showed a lot of us that the emperor is in fact naked.
The Wagner group's march on Moscow was unsuccessful. But for Nadya, the attempted coup revealed a weakness in Putin's armor.
He's not as strong as he used to be. He's not fighting on the good side of history. He's not fighting on the side of truth. And his army morale is just extremely, extremely low. So he's not going to win this war. Putin is just digging his own grave, unfortunately taking so many people with him.
Putin's opponents often seem to find themselves falling out of windows, poisoned. Do you think that might happen to you?
The father of my daughter got almost murdered with a military nerve agent, so it might happen.
Her former partner, just like the Russian opposition leader Alexei Navalny, survived a dose of the lethal nerve agent, Novichok. Just one drop on someone's skin can be deadly.
Well, you never know. So like, a person can pass me by, just touch my jacket, and I'm gonna just die, and it's something that can happen. But anyway, they're dumb, and it's like a lucky thing that the FSB is so dumb they don't know how to do their job properly. That's why we're still alive.
But do you think they want to kill you?
I mean, yeah, sure, why not? But I hope that they're going to be too dumb to actually do that. Or alternatively, they will kill me and I'm going to be dead and I won't be worried about it. So, all good.
Are you safe even coming here to a music festival in Australia?
I'm safer than in Russian jail, for sure.
There's a big debate about what weapons the West should give to Ukraine to help them win the war.
Everything. Everything you can. Because it's not going to end with just Ukraine. If you're not going to stop him in Ukraine, he's going to go further.
So is what we're giving them enough?
No, we should give more. Anything. The world that wants to keep being prosperous and peaceful needs to make sure that President Zelensky and his army have everything they need to defeat Putin.
The world's future depends on this, does it?
It really does.
That was powerful what she just said, right? That bullets can penetrate the body, but art can penetrate the mind. And Vladimir Putin knows this. If you discuss the war in Russia, you can be jailed. If you refer to the war in Ukraine as war and not a military operation, you can be jailed. So obviously people like Nadia, he's terrified of and wants to shut down. But, Sammy, you were there at Splendour on the weekend.
Yeah, I was there on the weekend and Hamish did like a one-hour in-conversation with her, and it was very powerful, very interesting. She used that term, the right side of history, quite a lot, and it really kind of, I think, showcased her thought process towards the whole thing. And hearing her talk in more detail about the labour camps that she was sent to, she's a very inspiring person.
The way she just says it so
matter-of-factly. The way she talks about death and her role in kind of the activism and where Russia is right now. It's very, very amazing.
It's kind of steel there, isn't it?